So in the last lecture, we built out this line chart and this area chart on our product detail page. But I feel like our line chart is kind of sad. It's showing profit by week, which is helpful, but I think we can pack some more information in here. And one way to do that is to use the tool tips like we've practiced already. So let's go ahead and grab some important measures like revenue and orders into our tool tips. That way, all three of those metrics are now visible at the weekly level without having to chart three separate series on the same graph, which would certainly be feasible, but not the best visual since those metrics are on very, very different scales. Instead, what I want to do is explore a pane that we haven't touched yet, which is this third option for analytics. Now, this pane will only be accessible for certain visuals, and for many, these options will be quite limited. But the line chart is one type of visualization that has very rich, very robust analytics options. So we're going to play with a couple of these here, starting with the trend line. Now, all we have to do is add a trend line, and it essentially fits a line to our series over time to give you an overall kind of smoothed out trend of where things are headed. So if I'm AdventureWorks, this is a great trend because I'm seeing profit on a nice upward slope over the last year and a half or so. Now, like everything else, the look and feel is completely customizable. In this case, that black line is pretty overpowering. So I'm gonna pull that down to about 75% transparency. That's a little bit more subtle, which I like. You can change the style to solid or dotted or dashed. I think I actually prefer the dashed here. And then these default options will do just fine. These come into play if you're dealing with multiple series. So that's our trend line, easy enough. We have very similar options for a constant line, a min, a max, an average, median, or percentile. All of these essentially add lines, horizontal lines to our chart, and they kind of speak for themselves. Constant allows you to define a value, like 100,000, for instance. And I typed a million. There you go, 100,000. And plot that horizontal line on your chart. That's nice if you have like a fixed goal or something like that. You can also plot the minimum line, which finds the smallest or lowest value in the window of time and applies a horizontal line based on that minimum. Same story holds for max up at the top. Kind of gives you a good sense of the range of values that you're looking at over this period. And then average, median, percentile, they all work exactly the same way. I don't want really any of those. We could add them, but I feel like it's just going to make things a little bit too busy in this case, especially because I want to play with one more tool, which is the forecast down here at the bottom. And this is how we're going to address that question for AdventureWorks about how is my profit expected or anticipated to look for the next X weeks or periods or months. So Power BI makes it very user-friendly to create forecast views like that. And all we're going to do is add a forecast. By default, it's created a forecast of 10 points, and points are basically date fields, and a point is the default unit of date that you're looking at. So in this case, it's 10 weeks out. And if you want to get totally wacky, you could do something like, you know, show me a forecast for 10 years. And it's very ridiculous because you very quickly lose confidence in what your profit's going to look like 10 years out. So I would not recommend that. And I don't think our clients would appreciate that much either. So let's stick with weeks. Let's actually narrow it down a bit to a 6-week forecast. Now you do have an option to ignore previous points. Like if this drop, if we know this was an outlier or an anomaly, we could ignore that one point. I kind of feel like that's sweeping things under the rug. So let's keep that at 0 and we'll keep the true forecast here. Now, confidence interval, this is an interesting one. And this basically defines at what level of confidence do we think the true values are going to fall into the shaded range. So at 95%, that's pretty darn confident, which is why you see a pretty broad or pretty wide range here. If we drop this down to 75 and apply, you see that it shrinks down quite a bit. And that's because we're trying to hit a tighter target. So naturally, we're less confident that the numbers will actually fall into this narrower range. So best practice is generally to use 90 or 95. Let's go with 90 for our purposes. There we go. And you can also apply a seasonality factor. Like if you know that mid-June or July profits tend to dip over the summer, then you can kind of manually tweak that forecast window yourself. So there you go. That's our forecast. I think I'm happy with that. Feel free to adjust the settings, kind of customize or personalize it as you see fit. But for our purposes, I think that does a nice job. It adds some good insight about the overall trend of profit and what we might expect to see for future profits over the course of the next 6 weeks.